All right, here we go. We're at the next job site. We're gonna start doing the excavation. We got the new 10 ton over here with Jay having his lunch on it. We're using that, traxles over there. We have access to the road back over there, so that's awesome to come in and out of the back here. It's a new development that's not finished yet, so we have some pretty good access right now. Here is the patio back here. So this is I think it's a 21 by 16 patio area. I'll put the drone in there too to give a different perspective of it. Back here there's gonna be an armor stone sitting wall in this back corner. There'll be a pad here that's laid on a 45 degree angle, so it'll be a different change up inlay. The colors and the patterns that we're using in the shop are really unique too. There's gonna be a material mixture. I think the main color is chestnut brown. There's a 20% cream beige and a 20% blue grande. Everything's blue smooth by techo-bloc. There's gonna be a wooden deck up here, so we're gonna prep the area for the deck guy, but we're not actually gonna be the ones building the wooden deck itself. On this unit over here, the same person owns both units, so they live here, and it's a rental property over here. So there's a patio in the back as well. It's a little bit smaller. I think this one is a 15 by 20 or 21 if I'm not mistaken. So it's all marked out too. We're gonna start excavating, get the base brought in here. On this job as well, we're also doing a lot of work in the front too, which we're gonna start next week. So the first part of the project will be working back here, getting all this dug out and start laying the blocks in. Then we'll work in the front next week, and we're doing some retaining walls and some cool stuff there as well. The guys are next door over here finishing up the last project that we're on, and then we'll be, the whole team will be over here to wrap up this one. So it should move pretty quick. So we'll get some cool footage of that and start digging. Let's do it. So yeah, that's dug out. The boys are now gonna put in some geomatting here. We're gonna be running the eaves trough like we did on the last job through here out to a drywall in the back, same as there'd be a perforated big O.
We have our big O runs out to the back. One perf, one solid, one goes up to the eaves trough, one just to take moisture out of the patio area here. Kyle is back in right now with that truck right there. He's got a load of clear stone. We'll get that out and dumped into the hole here and start setting the base and packing layers. Yeah, we're golden, baby girl, we're golden. They're about to see us shine, cause we're golden. They can never break us down, cause we're golden. They're about to see us glow, cause we're golden. Yeah, we're golden, baby girl, we're golden. They're about to see us shine, cause we're golden. They can never break us down, cause we're golden. They're about to see us glow, cause we're golden. Lima is digging out the driveway right now with the Yanmar, and getting this, all the clay pulled out of here and crap so that we can get some good base in here, get some geoclock down. The boss is here right now, the big boss, Kendall's here. He's actually driving our first truck ever we've ever purchased. This is our original truck, truck number one. Because we have this truck here is a 2019, the excavator here is a 22, this track here is 22, so it's pretty cool. to see the company grow, the different equipment, machines we have, stuff like that, and to see that's our first truck there. So it's kind of neat. When I first started working for my father and uncle's business, we were still using that truck every day. And now, actually, a guy that used to work for us way back in the day, like 20 years ago, bought that truck now. So it's kind of neat to just kind of see it keep going and see it being used. We don't use it much anymore. For me, it's actually pretty emotional to get rid of because there's just a lot of memories there. And again, to have the first vehicle you ever started with, it's just neat. So again, it's fun to watch the company progress, watch it grow, but it's cool to see those emotional attachments you can have to what most people think is that old, you know, crappy old truck. But to me, it means a lot. So it's definitely a sad, sentimental thing to see go, but there's lots of new things happening and changing in the business, so hopefully it's for the better. And I wish the new owner a lot of luck and success with whatever he plans on doing with it.
What's up, Lima? So there's Lima and Jed. They're doing their thing. Kyle's running the truck for them right now. He's only doing a little bit of gravel. We're heading in the back here.
Right now, the guys are starting to lay the armor stone accent sitting wall in the back here. And some guys are starting to lay pavers for the patio. Will was in here and is going to be in here in the machine here, laying in this armor stone wall. So right now we're still waiting on our rototilt from Rototilt. So please get us that rototilt right away. We got a grapple, a grade bar, a bunch of cool stuff, ditching bucket, trenching bucket. I think some other stuff too, but I forget what it is, the little pincer fingers and stuff. So it'd be super handy to have that right now, but we don't. So we're using this. We have a little attachment here that goes in the back of the bucket. So this is the little setup we have right now for putting in these armor stones. Chain goes on the back where you can put a clevis hook. And the good thing about this is it takes some guys on the ground to maneuver them. Because the way that chain comes up and comes down there, it's pretty easy to twist and maneuver and relatively safe to use as well. So over here is where the sitting wall is gonna go. So here's the outline for that, the face, so the edge of the brick. So the face is right there and over there. And this will basically be used as a little wall they can sit on. They're gonna put a little fire pit out over here. Be a little fire pit over there. So they use this armor stone wall as a sitting spot. Kind of a more natural look opposed to using the retaining wall. So I hope it's gonna look really good. Well, not hope, I know it's gonna look really good. And we're excited to get this in so we can start laying the inlays and the bricks and keep on keeping on.
Up to the sounds of the silence that allows for my mind to run around with my ear up to the ground. I'm searching to behold the stories that I told when my back is to the world that was smiling when I turned.
Vibrator in the box there. So the boys are putting a base up here, setting the sub base for the driveway, adding in 2-inch
geo matting's already in there, cloth is already in. So we got Lima and Jay up here setting in that sub base.
Boys are in the back here laying the patio and placing in the armor stone wall with the 10 ton. So we'll take a look at that and see how things are coming along back here.
There's our sitting wall, and here's the patio. You can start to see that that color mixture come to life. That cream beige is right there, and the chestnut is there. So you can see the two distinct colors, and then they have these grandes dispersed throughout. The ratio is supposed to be 20-20 for the cream and the grande, and then the rest is that that chestnut brown. And we're having some trouble right now with that clavicle over there, but I think we have one more stone to install there, and then that sitting wall is done. Just gonna have to adjust it, and then we can start finishing and finalizing all of the bricklaying up to that point in there.
Your words up on the wall as you're praying for my phone, and the laughter in the holes and the names that I've been called. I stack it in my mind and I'm waiting for the time when I show you what it's like to be worse fit in a mind. Tell you you're the greatest, but once you turn they hate. Oh, the misery. Everybody wants to be my enemy.
Okay, I'm hoping that somebody pray for me. I'm praying that somebody hope for me. I'm staying where nobody supposed to be. Papa posted, being a wreck of emotions. Ready to go whenever you let me know. The road is long, so put the pedal into the road.
The front stuff is mostly dug out and prepped. The backyard here, we have the armor stone sitting wall put in right there. We're just finishing up one of the cuts we did on this pad. We have to do a much more perimeter cuts tomorrow and finish off stuff. And but I'm gonna say the pad's about 70%, maybe 80% done. It's looking awesome, really cool design.
Well, I love the color ratio, the mixture here. It's looking awesome. Will's placing those Antiquas. We just made the cut for our radius there. So Will's just placing those Onyx Black Antiquas in right now.
And then that'll be a wrap for tonight. And then tomorrow we'll continue finishing the cuts on this pad, and we'll start working in the front on some really cool techo-bloc smoked pine borealis garden walls. So good day, boys, today, and we'll get back to it tomorrow.
Bring me a square.
Also, we have the pad laid in there now. We cut a cool design through the middle, I guess this way. The material inside of it's laid on a 45 degree angle into the armor stone sitting wall.
Dusty is over there working on the cuts. We're going to cut all those nicely into the armor stone. Looks nice and tight and clean. And then we've got to finish putting Antica around the perimeter here, around the window well. There's going to be a wooden deck right here, which is why there's nothing in there right now. So that'll be a wooden deck that'll be constructed next week to finish up the job by someone else. We don't do that kind of stuff usually. Then that's it, guys. So we're going to start working up front. I'm going to head up front here shortly and start prepping the front for the retaining walls and the apron, soldier coursing, and the landings we're building up there. So there's a good amount of interlock work up there. We're doing a really cool borealis smoke pine wall up front, so that'll look pretty neat. And the guys working back here finishing this up, and this project will be wrapped up. So hopefully by the end of the day today, most of the interlock work will be done. If not tomorrow, the job should be fully finished. And then we'll be on to the next one, which is a really cool project. We're doing actually a wheelchair ramp next. That'll be a fun one to watch that. So that's it, guys. We'll keep on here, and there's Will setting the grade right now for those Antiquas. And there's Harley and Dusty putting the cuts in. So again, a couple little details here just to wrap up, and then I'll try to get some clips of that for you guys. And again, we're gonna start working up front and make that look cool up there. We have to set the subgrade, pier stone, and then start putting those borealis walls. Just washed off the pad back here. The guys are done doing the Antica around the border and the cuts on the outside. So I'm gonna put the drone up in the air. We'll take a shot of it before we sand it, but I'll show you guys what it looks like. It looks super cool. So check this out. Again, it's a
a color mix ratio, so it has chestnut brown and cream beige. There's blue grandes, which are bigger size slabs in there. The ratio is 20, 20, and 20, with the inlay is the same pattern and material, just laid on a 45 degree angle up to the accent armor stone wall, with again a onyx black Antica border. So here it is, guys.
The Backstreet Boys playing in the background.
Everybody, yeah. Rock your body, yeah. Everybody, yeah. Rock your body right. Backstreet's back, alright. Again, brothers, sisters, everybody sing. Gonna bring the flame, I'll show you how. Got a question for you, better answer now. Yeah,
am I original?
Putting in this techo-bloc borealis wall. People tend to love this wall. It's really cool because it looks like real wood. It's this color smoke pine, very nice color. I'll show you guys what it looks like up close. Just gonna get a, not sure you can pick up on it there, but it has those wood grains into it. And they look like kind of like railroad ties or 6x6 kind of garden bed. So back here we're putting in, oops, through this way. We're putting in a garden bed back there, two-tier garden bed. And we have this clam here for our mini X that we use to pick up the pieces. It works nicely rather than putting them in my hand. So we're setting, this is the our base course for this. Most of this row will be buried. And there's gonna be a landing on that side over there and a landing over here. So I'll set up the GoPro and time-lapse us putting this garden bed in. And we'll probably try to take a video halfway through and show how it's looking, how it's coming along. But really beautiful wall. We also will be tying in this wall with what's called geogrid. Geogrid's right here. It's a
blade and drive.
This is what it looks like if you don't know. And what we do is when we put on our next row, we'll be gluing it, which is normal. But each time we go up into a row, because it's two-tier, we're going to put that geogrid across, glue it down, and then put the next row on top. So what will happen is, the first row will be glued into the second row. This theoretically means that if the wall were to pull or try to move one way or another, you have to pull both walls away from each other, so it kind of attaches one to the other. We also will structurally be tying it in with the material. So when you build a wall like this, as you come across with the material, some pieces tie also inwards this way into the house. So it's not just all linear, it actually goes into the house as well. And those are just tying points for structure. helps disperse the weight of the wall. And again, with that geogrid, it kind of attaches everything, kind of makes it as if it's all one unit all put together. So we cross grid it and we use geogrid, and that's a really strong way of putting it together, so it's going to last the customer a long time. Each house, and then it's a two-tier retaining wall. Lima's in the front here right now, and I'm trying to stay back here so we can get away from the noise at the moment, but Lima is right here. He's finalizing this driveway. There's no interlock on this property, but there is interlock on that one there, so I'm gonna come across here if it's not too loud. But right now Will and the boys are over here, so they're prepping this area over here for interlock. It's pretty hot today. It feels like 30 degrees. It's 28 degrees right now. This is the landing here. So there's the Borealis landing and wall. The color here is smoke pine. That's what that's looking like. We have a tri-mix soil to put in there. Here's your two-tier, your stack. All right, guys, this job is a wrap. We came in here actually yesterday, and we paved this driveway on this half yesterday. We didn't have enough asphalt, and we're doing a bunch of paves in this area now, so we came in today and paved this half. So this job's all done, guys. Everything's finally complete. I'll show you guys the finished product of this job. Again, everything is finally done. So there's the driveways in, retaining walls in. Over there, the homeowners put some beautiful flowers in there. It looks really nice. There's some amber mulch as well. Apron across the garage, soldier coursing along the side. Gives them a nice width here too, because I think the driveway now is 20 feet wide, I think. So it's a, to have a double driveway, 18 feet works. 20 is a great size, 22 is even bigger. Yeah, but 20 is a nice size for a double. So now they have a double driveway. And then they're working on the grade back here. So again, here's the back. Everything here is all done. Is a Antica border, techo-bloc in onyx black. Pattern is a cream and chestnut brown mix. Beautiful inlay, armor stone sitting wall. Everything's sanded now. You can see here they're working on the final grading back here, so this will all be done soon. And then the neighbor's patio as well, we did both at the same time. Same homeowner owns both. This is actually a rental unit for them, so we put this this patio in. And that's a wrap, guys. So again, thank you so much for the support. Thank you for watching. If you guys happen to like the channel, please subscribe, hit the like button, throw a comment in there. But this project's done, we're super happy. Someone's dumping their box out. How it turned out. And again, we're gonna keep these videos going for you guys. I'm really enjoying doing this. It's a great way to show off our work. It's a great way to involve the team in something that's kind of fun for all of us to do together. Super proud of all the team as well. The guys are doing awesome this year. We have a great team of guys. Everyone gets along, everyone's having fun, and that's what's important. It's to enjoy what you do, have fun at work doing it. We work with each other all day long. We put in some long hours together, and it's there's no better feeling than actually being at work with guys that you enjoy working with, doing work that you're proud of and you enjoy doing. It goes a long way. So thank you for the team. Thank you for the customers, for all your support, and we'll catch you guys in the next one. Thanks so much.